Holy howdy. Now this is an exciting time for our folks. Well, let's see. I could eat them to replenish my units by 5%.
Don't you need to sacrifice a whole load of them to get,
Yeah, I do. Alright. To get that legendary lord.
Yeah.
And I want him. I want him real bad.
I want him. I want him all. I want it all. And I want it now.
Dude, I do want it now. How do you, oh, there we go.
How do I live without you?
So I've got my two Bray Herds plus my two armies. Come at me, dwarves.
I'm gonna see how this goes.
Ooh.
Yeah.
This is, you're auto-resolving.
Yeah.
That's a bold move, Cotton.
Sweet.
It's a close victory. You only lost 400 dudes.
I know, but the game's like, oh, what a close victory. And I'm like, no, I did fine, really. I don't know.
Congratulations, Dragon, on your platinum victory.
Yay. What's a platinum victory?
He's playing Mass Effect, and he found a resource called platinum. He needed it to build an item.
Okay. I don't have that.
By the way, did you complete your quest?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay,
and I need to...
Also, is this your random guy that you've just got sitting here?
Where?
The guy that you just moved?
Oh, yeah. I just had him there to do the quest.
GamerRodK asks, am I excited for the possibility of doing a Skaven multiplayer when the sequel comes out?
He will not be Skaven unless there is an option for both of us to be Skaven.
I will definitely be Skaven every single opportunity that there is to be Skaven.
Yeah, honestly, like, I'm happy being Lizardmen as well. Or Dark Elves, to be honest. I do enjoy the Dark Elves.
I could also be Skaven or Lizardmen. I don't know enough about... Dark Elves to know if they get past my loathing of normal elves.
What would help? Like, cause I
don't know. Are they poncy, uptight assholes that fire bows at people and think that they're better than everybody else?
Okay. So they have the Witch Elves, who are crazy ladies who don't wear really any armor at all and basically rip people apart.
Okay.
They have Cold One Riders, which are basically knights which ride pretty much what amount to Velociraptors.
Okay, Velociraptors is pretty cool.
Yeah, they have, like, repeater bolt throwers, which are, like, bolt throwers, but machine guns, I guess.
But not, okay.
Yeah, what else? Yeah, they've got, they're quite heavy armored and they're quite melee focused, I'd say, because they like to inflict pain.
Okay, well, you know what? That sounds better than normal poncy elves.
Well, I mean,
I believe I may be down.
I mean, normal poncy elves are similar to dark elves, except for they're poncy. Dark elves are a little bit poncy, but they're more like pant sweatingly insane and evil. So, you know, like...
I'm going to auto-resolve this.
Oh, I thought you said not for a second there, and I was like, why would you not auto-resolve that? Yeah, no, fair enough.
And I'm going to raise and defile this, because 104 monies is not worth my time.
Yes. That pretty much sums up the Dark Elves. Dark Elves equals elves, but with added murder, rape, kill, destroy. And
well,
stabby.
Then, I like them already. I mean, they're not Lizardmen or Skaven, but they're understandably not poncy elves.
Yeah. Okay. So... Oh, it's still your go. Never mind.
You're good, man. You're good. Please embed yourself into the hero.
Okay, so you know it said close victory on the, Oh, never mind.
Woo! I can give Goro's Heart Render a Razor Gore Chariot.
Oh, hell yeah.
Oh, but it drops his melee attack and weapon strength by a lot.
Ah, you just, like, boost it
and
up.
And his armor, and his leadership. The only thing it increases is speed.
Oh, and charge.
Actually, no, it does not increase his charge bonus.
Wow.
I don't think I'm going to give him a Razor Core Chariot, to be entirely honest. No, I'm okay. I'm okay. His weapon strength is now 657.
Huh. How's How's Grimgore doing? Grimgore has 130 armor, 92 leadership, 38 speed, 84 melee attack, 51 melee defense, 674 weapon strength, and 65 charge bonus.
Nice. Goros is at 128 armor, 85 leadership, 48 speed, 121 melee attack, and it's magical attack, 56 yeah. melee defense, 657 weapon strength, and 85 charge.
Nice. Oh, and 5,359 health.
Nice.
Yeah.
4,497, so you gotta be beat on health by quite a bit.
Well, once I get Gitsnik and the Bloodforged armor, then Grimgore's going to be basically unkillable.
So, I could... currently, he has Primeval Club, which gives 7 armor piercing, 7% weapon strength.
Mm.
I kind of want to give him the Shrieking Blade to give him a tribute causes fear, a tribute causes terror.
Causes terror? Jesus.
I kind of want to do that. Yeah, I think I'm going to do that, as a matter of fact. There you go, bud. Go ahead and cause terror.
I mean, you know, yeah. I'm pretty sure the Gorbald causes terror himself anyway, so I may as well put it on him. Or causes fear, maybe. Let's go.
I'm actually going to take Glittering Scales off of Malgor because he doesn't join into armor, or he doesn't join into fights near enough. I'll give my level 1 guy this. I'll give him the Primeval Club. And the good old Pendant of Slaanesh.
Slaanesh! Yeah.
Sometimes I say things wrong. Really, just to
piss I off. Have noticed. I didn't know it was to piss me off, but I have noticed.
That's gonna be the end of my turn. You guys all have your targets, right? Cool. Alright. Let's see. Nice, Dragon Saint. Dark Elves are basically BDSM bananas.
Yep.
Fair enough. Dark Elves equals elves, but with extra murder, rape, kill, destroy. Yeah. Dark Elves are basically elves that are emo. Not what I gathered there. Although they do earn points for being the universe's chew toy, as much as they like to butt fluff the other races, the universe likes to butt fluff them.
Mm-hmm.
Poor dark elves. Mm. No, they're not edgelords. They're sadomasochists with a lot of fun weapons and more slaves than you could count. I'm learning so much about dark elves right now. That goes double for Melikith and the Malleus Darkblades. They've got royally shafted by fate. I mean, the full 12 inches, ribs, studs, spikes, and all. Full force, no lube.
Yeah, they did.
Oh my.
Poor Malekith. Poor Malekith.
Oh my. By the way, what are you doing with your one little hero there?
He needs to go and damage a settlement.
Fair enough.
Yeah, it's part of my quest for the Bloodforged armor.
I still haven't gotten any of those character quests.
Are you sure?
I'm pretty sure.
Like, okay, so... one sec. No. So, if you go... You see in the top right, you've got events, and then to the left of that, the bit slightly bigger, like, scroll, you've got mission and quests. And the ones that say quests are the one... You've got missions, which are just basically, like, you know, go and capture somewhere or do something. And then you got quests.
Oh, okay. I do actually have one. I'm sorry. Raid any region belonging to the following province. Emperor province with the following lord's army. Malagor, the Dark Omen.
So take Malagor and raid the Empire, basically.
Okay, well... The border princes don't count as Empire.
No, it has to be actual, the full-on Empire.
So where the fluff are the Empire?
In Matorka, weirdly. Oh, no, they're not, sorry. They must be, to the north. Like, you see the passage going north? Just up there.
Yeah, just above where I am.
Yeah.
Okay. Okie dokie, I guess we're gonna take a break from beating the shit out of these yellow guys.
Well, I mean, you've got...
Or... I can go beat the shit out of these yellow guys and then swing up.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, you guys go, both of you guys go to Matorka, and we are going to work our way to go fluff with other people. Not like I shall save my people, the universe. Okay, I hear you. But how about instead? You end up dooming both your people and the world to be consumed by the ruinous powers, and become so hated even your own kin won't speak your name. Malekith. Wait, what? Yeah.
Pretty much.
Yeah. Yeah. I think I remember seeing that plot before.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you remember that other game with elves and orcs and humans that fight across the generations?
I mean, like, this
and, and there were ruinous demon powers, and there was an elf that tried to save his people, but then opened up the ruinous powers and became corrupted. I mean, I'm not accusing Blizzard of anything, but saying.
Seriously, Blizzard. Seriously. I'm not accusing them of anything, but come on, guys, that's just a little bit obvious, isn't it?
I mean, but seriously, though, I mean, everybody's like, man, World of Warcraft is so unique and new. Have you ever looked at Warhammer? Warhammer 40k?
You remember that place with Warhammer 40k?
No, you haven't? Okay. Totally unique and new. Hey, Art of Stuttering, hooray for co-op! Hooray for co-op indeed.
Hooray, hooray, it's a wonderful day.
We'll never get you down. Cooperation makes it easy to stream for long times because you don't have to carry the whole load of entertaining people by yourself, especially when, you know, Sheepdog is generally just blathering on about entertaining stuff and you don't have to do any work at all. Cooperation.
I can blather. Oh boy, I can blather.
Oh, you are quite the blatherer, sir. That's what they get for murder fluffing Slanesh into existence. you're not wrong.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, you know, with Slanesh is fun, but
Slanesh is a hoot and or holler. And also, consequently, pretty sure that was how we were all gonna die. But
well, you say that, but then there is still the deal with the Huntsman.
Oh, Gilead's back. Gilead has returned from absence.
Sweet.
Once again, I'm glad to have him back. Also, glad to know that you were wrong.
Well, I said probably.
No, you didn't. You said definitely. You literally said the words definitely.
Debatable.
No, it's not debatable. It is a literal thing that you said.
Debatable, I feel.
No. Debatable means that it is up for debate and verifiably not.
Well, I mean, I'm disagreeing with you. You're disagreeing with me. This feels like a debate to me. No,
you're wrong.
Am I though?
Yes. Yes, you are.
I know. It sounds debatable.
You're definitely wrong. Is the thing though.
Sounds debatable. I would probably debate that.
You're probably gonna debate that.
I'll debate that.
Okay. Well, I mean, if you've got to debate it.
What are you saying? Yujoon is basically sheepy. Doesn't shut the fluff up. Yeah, he does.
No, I'm saying that he has the gift of blather, which in a YouTube and Twitch environment is a very good gift.
Well, especially in a YouTube environment.
The ability to continue talking while being entertaining is super important if you want to actually be
entertaining.
You know, a good streamer or a good YouTuber. The old gift of gab. The blessing of bullshit.
Yeah. It helps that when I'm sleep deprived, which is most nearly all the time, I don't make any sense and I babble on.
Five? You said babble on. I was just finishing the sentence.
Oh. Yes. I babble on five.
Thank you. It's so good to have Gilead back. I was legitimately worried there. I was like, I have fluffed myself. I have fluffed myself so incredibly hard.
So hard.
So hard. Wait, so the vast unending war horde says recruitment costs minus 5% for hero's army. Does that mean just the army that he is attached to?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, it does.
Holy shit, leadership plus 20 for Hero's Army.
Mm-hmm.
You will never break. Ever.
You hold.
You will hold. But instead, Woundmaker, an unnatural thirst. So here are Gilead's stats. 6,786 HP, 113 armor, 62 leadership, 64 speed, 93 melee attack, 48 melee defense, 498 weapon strength, with a bonus versus large and armor piercing, and 96 charge bonus.
Damn. He's a man.
He's a man. He's a man, baby.
I do really like, what's that? It's called Channel Awesome, but it's a Nostalgia Critic. Like, every now and then, I'll go on a bent for Nostalgia Cricket and Cricket. Nostalgia Critic and just watch a whole load.
Nice.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. I think I'm going to take the items away from.
Yeah.
And I think I actually might fire this hero. Nah.
Why don't you just turn him into an assassin? Clearly, you need one.
Mad Gub Blightbringer the Assassin?
Yeah.
Do Gorbals make decent assassins?
They make better melees, but...
Yeah, I mean, I'd rather just fire and get rid of the upkeep.
What other heroes do you have to recruit?
None.
Spray Shamans, yeah.
Bray Shamans, yeah.
Yeah, the Beastmen aren't the most agent-y that's ever existed. Like, they don't fit in, you know, they don't, like, blend into the surroundings kind of thing.
I like the charge bonus. Sword of Anti-Heroes. We're gonna give him that. So he loses a little bit of charge bonus, but Sword of Anti-Heroes is... good. Okay. End of my turn. Gilead is a beast, not a man. It's all right. Tentacly fluff hole. Oh, now, oh my. Stop being Nietzsche's tentacly fluff hole. Oh, goodness. Sheeple debate the morality of a corpse if asked to. Would you, sheep?
Sure, why not?
Or mortality. Excuse me, not morality. Mortality of a corpse.
I mean, you know, the morality of the corpse, why not?
Yeah, why not? Joey Jerry, hey bud, it has been a while. It's been going well. Lots of good games. Having a good time. I wonder how a Skaven Beastman campaign would go if it's possible. That would actually probably be a better campaign for co-op than Skaven or Beastman Orc. Because at least the Skaven are okay with chaos, right?
Kind of.
Fair enough.
Okay, yep, I've got this. Sweet.
You hold in the face of a giant bear where your weapon doesn't even scale to a toothpick. March forward! Always march forward. This looks like a tough fight here, my friend.
I mean, sure.
Looking forward to Warhammer 2? Yes. Yes, I am. So, I mean, now there are two games that Sheepdog and I are pretty much required to play together.
Yeah.
Dawn of War 3 and
Hell yeah.
Total War Warhammer 2. I'm actually looking forward to both of them, because both of them have proven to be pretty good entries into the Warhammer kind of series, but they're very different, so it's nice.
Yeah. I enjoyed the Dawn of War 2, but I enjoyed Dawn of War 1 more. So yes. From what people are saying, it's like, oh, this is gonna be good. So,
well, Dawn of War 1 was more unit based. Dawn of War 2 was more hero based.
Yeah.
I hope Dawn of War 3 goes back to more unit based, or at least gives me the option of being more unit and tactical based. Is this a story mission?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I told me by talking sight. My time's best spent killing stunties. Or stunties. If you want to come and kill some stunties too, then come. But don't be getting in my or the immortal's way. I don't care who's under me, Trotter. If it's your skull instead of some stupid stunty, I'll laugh just as hard. Come on then, let's go and scalp stunty beards.
Not the most impressive orc war cry I've heard, to be honest.
No.
Come on, let's There you go, I know you want it.
Oh, I want it. I want it real bad. You're hopping in on that Dawn of War 3? Nice, Floof. Yeah, man, it'll be interesting to see how the multiplayer will work. I'm hoping that we'll be able to go through the Dawn of War 3 campaign as a multiplayer. That is my hope, anyway. My regular gaming buddy fell out with Total War after Rome 2 came out broken, and though I wanted Warhammer, I didn't want to buy it without his co-op investment, but now he's looking persuaded by Warhammer 2, so maybe. Well, Joey, that is actually the exact same story of our good friend Sheepdog here, who also fell out of love. He was all out of love.
I'm not out of love. I'm so lost without you.
God damn it, I love you, buddy. anyway, so he fell out of love with the series because of the multiple goddamn missteps of anyway,
sorry, I'm concentrating really hard because I just realized they have an organ gun, and no, basically the entirety of my no is saved for fucking organ guns.
Yeah.
Go and just zoom in on it for a second and have an idea of what it is.
I see the the unit. Oh, there it is. Oh, that, that doesn't, no, that's not great.
Yeah, it's a butt.
it's a little bit of a butt.
It's a butt.
So, like I was saying, so he fell out of love with it, but then they attached Warhammer, they slapped Warhammer on it, and he's like, you bastards, now I have to buy it. And I mean, he did have to buy it.
I did.
That was the rules.
I did have to buy it, and I did also, like, I pre-ordered it, I went full balls deep on that shit.
He broke all of the rules he's ever made about anything.
Yeah.
Involving games, but I think I would say that you've been rewarded for such a thing. I mean, this is a solid game.
Sure.
I'm attacking the organs with my gentleman.
Yeah. I just basically put all of my archers on the organ guns.
The organ guns are having a bad goddamn day.
Yeah, all of my artillery, all of my archers, just I put everything on those organ guns, because, like, fuck those organ guns, man. Fuck your jibber-jabber, foo.
Got them! They are now broken.
Uh-oh! Around. Explosions. Can I hit them?
Doom Diver to death. I'm gonna start launching my Doom Diver into these guys that are just waiting to crash into your ass.
Yeah.
Because they're literally just big piles of dwarves. I mean,
oh,
I'm bad at aiming, but fish barrel. What Total Wars have I played? I played Shogun 2, Rome 1 and 2, and Attila. And this one, obviously.
I have played every single Total War game.
Chibi, would you like a Warhammer game set in Grand Strategy, like Europa and Hearts of Iron?
I want a Warhammer game, Warhammer 40,000 game set up like Stellaris or Master of Orion.
That would be awesome.
Yep.
That actually would be super cool, especially if you could, like, change between the different groups. Because, you know, obviously humans managing the Imperium, yada yada, yakety schmackety.
Yeah.
But if you could, like, choose a Chaos God and then have to work, like, corrupting different planets and then bringing them under your sway, and... or the orcs.
Just all, like, of it would be awesome. Just,
yeah, I mean, all of it would work, and it would work really well, actually.
See, right. This is the thing, is people sometimes underestimate my insane fanboyness for Warhammer, and, like, and they're like, oh, so Sheepy, what do you think about this? And I'm just like, I have thought about this 300 times in my life, and I
thought about this 300 times this morning.
Yeah, it's down to the minutest details, and yeah.
Right. Well, it looks like we're going to have to form a game studio, and I'm upside down and have missed.
I mean, I've thought repeatedly, for example, on the best way to improve Total War. And, like, how to have, like, a really fun, like, how I would have done Total War Warhammer. Like, I would have changed it up significantly.
Yeah.
Like, not saying that it's bad, just saying, like...
changes. Yeah, no, I got you. But, like, yeah, no, I think we are now going to form a gaming company and get the rights to Warhammer. And
I mean, it's easy to get
Warhammer
the rights
40K
to Warhammer nowadays.
I mean, I don't think we have an option. Like,
no.
I think
Oh, and another game that's coming out, which is going to be awesome, Necromunda. Well, let's be very, very clear. I really, 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 really hope it's going
to
be awesome.
You want it to be awesome.
Yeah.
Wanting it to be awesome and saying it's going to be awesome.
Yeah, you can't say for definites that it's going to be awesome, but I have my hopes and my dreams.
You had Squig Raiders there, but I wonder if I can hit that guy out of the sky.
Give it a shot.
Damn it. I missed. I hit a clip.
Yeah, you did.
I mean, in fairness, that's a hard target to hit.
Yes. Very hard. The hardest, in fact. How are these? Oh, they're slayers? What the hell am I doing fighting slayers with my trolls?
Shit! Now starting a Kickstarter for Sheepy to make a gaming company.
Yeah.
It's a good use of your funds.
Well, I mean, like, this is the thing, right? Is my idea for a Warhammer Total War style game? Because it's not really Total War. Just because of how it is, like, how the idea runs.
Yeah.
But it's... Oh, nice shot. But the basic idea behind it is you have a unit, right? So, like, say... Say, for example, Yujoon, when he starts his game, he can make a Doomdiver Catapult unit. And then you search for a game, you join an army which has a general.
Mm-hmm.
The general doesn't own any units, he gets players in to his army. And then he puts down orders, and he has, like, special abilities to, like, boost and this kind of thing. So, like, Yujoon would be in the artillery section of the army. And then you set up and you control the one unit. And the unit has, like, really in-depth, customizable soldiers. So, like, you can get right down and name all of your soldiers. You can give them special equipment and this kind of thing as you level up and all this kind of stuff. And as time goes on, you know, people will form clans and have clan armies. So, you know, you have one army against another army. And, like, you know, obviously, if it's just a pug, like a throw-together multiplayer battle, it's probably not going to be amazing. But if you get organized and have, like, let's say 20 to 30 players all playing with their, you know, specific units which they're good with, you could have like a really fun game, I think.
Yeah, I can see how that would be a lot of fun.
Mm.
I just, talking about it from a viability standpoint, you're talking about, okay.
Oh, I never talk about viability.
One of us has to be the business guy. So. But I mean, if you assume an army has, what, 20 units?
Yeah.
So that means you need 21 players on each side before you can ever start a match.
No.
Because if you're doing 20 unit
matches. Yeah, yeah, if you're doing 20 unit matches, but what you do is you have, like, 5, 10, 15, 20 unit matches.